In the first Profibus video, Network Acceptance, you got to know the handling of the Profibus Tester 5. Therefore, this video does not explain every detail of the handling. In this video, you will get an introduction to systematic troubleshooting in a Profibus network. You will learn to locate and document the cause of errors. Therefore, you not only need the Profibus Tester 5, but also need the latest software Profibus Diagnostic Suite on your computer. As a first step, you must create a project in the Diagnostic Suite, in which the measurements are then saved. To do this, click on New Network. Select Add New Project. Click Continue and enter the name of your project. We call it Plant 5. Click Continue and name your network to measure, for example, Network 1. Select Save. If you have a repeater in the system, you must create another network for the area behind the repeater and repeat all the steps described for this network. For the actual troubleshooting, you create three measuring locations. Click on Test Locations and enter names for the sites. We call them Beginning, Center and End. Click OK. At this point a note, the actual measuring locations do not need to be exactly at the beginning, end or in the middle, but only approximately. Plug the meter into one of the measuring locations. Select the Signal Quality tab and select your measuring location. Start the measurement. The measurement should run until the red arrow below the green bars has turned 5 to 10 rounds. Stop the measurement. Now plug the meter over and select your next measuring location. Start the measurement. Again, the measurement should take 5 to 10 turns of the red arrow. Now you plug the meter to the third location and proceed as before. After you have stopped the third measurement, select Test and save network status to save the measured values. Now the measurements have to be evaluated. The three measurements are compared. The rating is based on the average level. The average value is also displayed as a number. A principle applies. The worse the measurement result, the closer the measurement location is to the cause of the error. If the worst of the three measurement locations is determined, this does not mean that the error is exactly there too, but at least it is close to it. Now the cause of the error is further circled. To do this, create two more measuring locations. Before worst and after worst. Now measure the levels at the two new measuring locations. Again, compare the three readings. Again, the cause of the error is close to the worst reading. Now proceed according to this scheme until you have found the worst overall location. There is the cause. In our case, determination at the beginning is missing. This happens, for example, if the shifter on the bus connector is set to on, but the internal switch did not engage correctly. Correct the error. Measure again at least two measuring locations. To do this, create two new locations. Start fixed and end fixed. Now the values are much better. When the last measurement is stopped, select Test and save Network Status to save the measured values. Now you can do the report. To do this, select Test and create Report. In the mask that appears, enter the data of the customer, the data of the person measuring, and if desired, a free text, for example, the cause of the problem. Press continue, then the report will be created. Save the report in PDF format. Close the report preview. Close the report's settings window. Move the mouse over projects. Select your test report and open it with a double click. In addition to the cover sheet, the report now contains all the relevant technical data, such as bitrate, cycle time, and physical values. In this example, we have dealt with the reason missing bus termination. In principle, however, it does not matter what the cause of the error is. The procedure with the three measuring locations in comparison stays the same. For more complex problems, Softing offers well-established hands-on training for systematic troubleshooting.